Okay, I will start the class. Today we will be learning about Hoffman. Okay, so before that, let's talk about the syllabus, where we are. So right now, the solution for solution of week 7 is out. And data of week 9 is also out, and the last date is 27/9. Okay, so we started our practice session 1, where we did some transport theorem, then practice session 2 was 3D transport theorem, and in further part of the course we will learn planar kinetics of rigid bodies as well as kinematics of rotation. So these all come into the same topic called transport theorem. So these examples are done. Then moving on to particle kinetics. So for that, practice session 3 and practice session 4 was organized, in which Newton's laws were the main or we can say Newtonian dynamics. So in that we covered particle kinetics as well as kinetics of the system of particles, and next we did work energy theorem, work energy relationship. So if we combine that with transport theorem, we reach this point. Work energy relations. And impulse momentum. We also did particle impact. So now we are at this point, central force motion, and we are solving some amazing problems of orbit transfer. So first of all, what is Hoffman transfer? it was given by the German scientist Walter Hormann. And it is often the most fuel efficient ways to get from one circular orbit to another circular orbit. Okay. Now here we shall look at the energy required for the first step of this process. Okay. So our aim is putting a satellite into an elliptical transfer orbit. So we need energy required for the step. This process, then we will look at the second step where the satellite is now transferred into a circular geostationary orbit. So the problem is to find the problem is to find the energy. E-launch. To launch the satellite. Now this E-launch is the difference like 2RE. So this is the figure. So next we can find the energy. Hello? Yes, Amarjit. हेलो, यस, हाँ बताइए। हाँ जी बताइए, कोई डाउट है आपको? ओके, तो इट इज इक्वल टू पोटेंशियल एनर्जी प्लस के नॉट। ऑलरेडी इट्स फ्रॉम सम रेडियस ऑफ अर्थ, सो दैट मच प्लस के नॉट। तो दिस इज द पोटेंशियल एनर्जी। So reference is center of the earth and K naught is initial kinetic energy. Let's say if launch is from the equator, yes. So then K naught will be equal to half m V naught square, where V naught can be given as R e into capital omega e, where capital omega e is given by 2 pi by 864. So in a day, how many seconds are there? So that much radian per second. So it is angular speed of Earth combining the energies. Calculation, this comes out to be 1.25 into 10 raised to 11 joules. So actually launching from the equator decreases E ground by less than some 0.2%, and which actually is not seem significant, but if you have to do some maneuver, then the amount of fuel consumed is roughly proportional to the required change in velocity. So actually the earth rotation, it saves fuel. Radius plus the perigee point plus the apogee point and one more time radius. So this comes out to be 10 joule. So difference between E orbit minus E ground will give us the energy required for launching the satellite. Now for angular momentum, we first have to find R minimum, which is equal to, we'll use the eccentricity formula. And for Max. Now we can solve for the eccentricity. If you doubt, you can type in the chat also. So we know that R max plus R min is equal to A. So this will come out to be 0.70. Also, we know that eccentricity square is equal to 1 plus 2e orb l square by mc square, and upon filling the value, E or value we know, we need to find L, and all the other quantities are known. So this will give us L as 1.43 into 10 to the power 14 kg meter square per second angular momentum. So we know angular momentum L, and since the velocity is perpendicular, the radius vector, So this gives our VP as L by M RP. So this comes out to be 9530 meter per second. Now similarly at apogee we can find VA is equal to L by MRA, and this comes out to be 1690 meter per second. So at satellite, when it will be at apogee, it will have this much velocity. So now our aim has changed. Now we want to transfer the 2000 kg satellite into a circular geostationary orbit. So aim 2. So we need to transfer the 2000 kg satellite into a circular geostationary orbit. So what we know that its orbital speed in the geostationary will be 3070 meter per second, but from right now its speed is 2000 kg in the elliptical orbit. It only 1690 meter per second. So so if the satellite is moving with velocity v, the story was like this, and now it will change to this. So this is our let me change the color. So this yellow one is our geostationary orbit. And what we are saying about like V. in news, you would be knowing about Aditya L1 mission, and that is a similar maneuver which is done. So at that point, at perigee, we push the satellite so that it goes to a different orbit. Something like that happens. So this completes our one more question. First, let's start the time varying mass. Let's take a 5-minute break. Okay, figure, draw figure. Okay. So, just